We have been learning about shapes in maths for quite some time. Now, why do you think an understanding of shapes is very important? Now, as you can see in these pictures, an understanding of shapes has helped people to build buildings, pyramids, cars, different equipments like sports equipments, and also a very, very simple thing like this stop sign. So in every case, an understanding of shapes is very important. So let us find out about a few shapes and try to understand them better. All these pictures that you see on the screen are different kinds of shapes. As you can see, if you consider any shape, let us say this shape or this shape, they are all made up of line segments. As you can see, this is made up of three line segments, and this is known as a triangle. Even take, for example, this shape. It is made up of four line segments. But if you look closely, can you tell me which one is the odd one out among all these shapes? That's right. The odd one out is this particular blue circle. Why? Because all the other shapes are made up of line segments. But if you notice closely, the circle is not made up of any line segments. It is completely round in shape. So let us talk about those shapes which are made up of line segments. Such shapes which are made up of a certain number of line segments, three or more, are known as polygons. The word poly means many, and the word gons means sides. So it means a many-sided shape. So now we are going to talk about certain kinds of polygons which have four sides. For example, this particular shape, it is a polygon and it has four sides. So we are going to talk about such kinds of polygons. Such polygons are known as quadrilaterals. Now, the word quadrilaterals has been derived from two Latin words, quadri and lattice. What does quadri mean? Quadri means four. So as you can see, all the shapes that have been shown on the screen over here have four sides. For example, this shape has four sides. You consider any other shape, that will also have four sides. And lattice means sides. So in other words, quadrilaterals refers to those shapes that have four sides. Now, quadrilaterals are shapes which are very common in our daily lives. If you consider various objects which you come across or encounter in your daily life, you will see that most of them have four sides. A regular calculator, a wall clock, the computer screen on which you are watching this video, the table at which you read or study, a regular bag, and even a windowsill. So all of these shapes that you can see on the screen over here are quadrilaterals because they have four sides. So obviously, a better understanding of quadrilaterals is necessary because we encounter them so frequently. Now, quadrilaterals is a term which is commonly used to refer to polygons which have four sides. There are certain other terms that are also used. The other terms are quadrangle, in keeping with the analogy for a triangle. A triangle means a polygon which has three sides or three angles. So a quadrangle means a polygon which has four angles. As you can see, this particular polygon which has been shown, A, B, C, D, has four angles. Angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. Quadrilaterals are also known as tetragons, in keeping with the analogy pentagons or hexagons. Now, pentagon has five sides, hexagons have six sides, and so on. In a similar manner, tetragon has four sides because the word tetra means four. So over here, as you can see, the polygon ABCD has four sides: side AB, side BC, side CD, and side DA. But commonly, we do not use the words quadrangle or tetragon. We use quadrilaterals to refer to four-sided polygons. So now let us perform a very simple experiment to find out what the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is. So for this experiment, take a cardboard and draw any quadrilateral as you please, as A, B, C, and D. Any quadrilateral with four sides. And then mark out the angles as you can see over here. Now perform a simple activity. Once you have marked out these angles, cut them out exactly as you have marked them along the sides. And after cutting them out, arrange them in a way that I'm going to show you right now. So over here, I take angle 1 and I place it like that. After that, I take angle 2. So I take angle 2 and I arrange it and place it adjacent to angle 1. After that, I will take angle 3. I take angle 3 and again I place it adjacent in a manner so as to coincide it with angle 1. I place it side by side. And lastly, I will take angle 4. I take angle 4 and I rearrange it so as to fit it completely. So what is the shape that I have obtained? That's right, I have obtained a circle. Now you must be knowing that the total number of angles in a circle is 360 degrees. So what does this mean? This means that the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. Now you might be having some doubt in your mind as to how this might be happening. So now let us try to prove this mathematically in order to remove your doubts. So I have taken any quadrilateral A, B, C, and D, and I have marked out the angles as A, B, C, and D. Now in order to prove that the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees, I have to perform a very simple activity at first. Firstly, I will join B and D. So once I join BD, what do I get? I get two triangles, triangle A, B, and D, and triangle B, C, D. Now in triangle ABD, I have marked out two angles, angle 1 and angle 2. Now since sum of interior angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees, I can say in triangle ABD, angle 1 plus angle A plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. Likewise, if I consider triangle BCD, I can mark this as angle 3 and mark this as angle 4. So in a similar manner, I can write angle 3 plus angle C plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees. So I have now two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. So what do you think I will get if I add these two equations? I now add equation 1 and equation 2. So let us see what that gives rise to. If I add equation 1 along with equation 2, I get an equation which looks somewhat like this. Angle 1 plus angle A plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle C plus angle 4 equal to 180 plus 180. So this is the equation that I am getting. Now I will perform certain manipulations. Over here, I take angle A first and I group together angle 1 and angle 3, that is this angle. I group together angle 1 and angle 3. I place angle C as it is, and then I group together angle 2 and angle 4. So I write and group angle 2 and angle 4. 180 plus 180 is equal to 360 degrees. So I write 360 degrees. So this is what I get. Now if you look closely at the figure that I have drawn, you will find that angle 1 plus angle 3 is nothing but angle B, and similarly angle 2 plus angle 4 is nothing but angle D. So I can rewrite this equation as angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degrees. Now obviously, as you can see, angle A, B, C and D are the interior angles of the quadrilateral, and their sum is equal to 360 degrees. Thus, it has been proved that the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. And this is true for any quadrilateral. If you have a quadrilateral like this, the sum of interior angles will be equal to 360 degrees. Even if you have a quadrilateral like this, the sum of interior angles will be equal to 360 degrees. So no matter what kind of quadrilateral it is, the sum of interior angles is always equal to 360 degrees. So now I have a problem for you. It is a very simple problem, and it states that three angles of a quadrilateral A, B, C and D have been given. Angle A is equal to 75 degrees. Angle B is equal to 88 degrees. Angle D is equal to 110 degrees. And we have been asked to find out and calculate the value of angle C, which is an unknown angle X. Now, what have we studied so far? We have studied that the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. So I can write angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degrees. What does this mean? This means that if I add the values of A, B, C and D, I will get a value equal to 360 degrees. So 75 plus 88 plus X plus 110 will give me 360 degrees. So 75 plus 88 plus X plus 110 is equal to 360 degrees. Now I add the known values and I take them to the other side in order to get the value of X. So once I perform that, I will get X is equal to 360 degrees minus 75 plus 88 plus 110, and that gives me the value of X as 87 degrees. So we found out through the property that sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is always equal to 360 degrees, the value of the unknown angle X.